Hello everyone and welcome to BISP Solutions. I am CA Sanjana Mishra working as the lead functional consultant at BISP Solutions. BISP Solutions is a tech company providing technological solutions across the globe. Today we'll be looking at vendor installment payments into the Oracle NetSuite application. So into the vendor installment payments, we'll see what are vendor installments and how do we proceed with that? How do they work into an organization? How can we set up this vendor installment into the NetSuite application? And then we'll take a case where we'll be paying a vendor through the installments. So let us start. Vendor installment payments is when you purchase something from a vendor. Vendor installment payments feature into the NetSuite application allows you to pay to that vendor into installments. So at the time of billing, what you can do is you can select the term of payment as the installment, and it will automatically be created as 4, 5, 6, how many installments that you have as per the contract with the vendor. Those installments will be created and they will automatically show up when they are due. This is also helpful for the detailed aging analysis, because every installment is taken up as a different bill. So that means aging for installment one will be different, for installment two will be different, for installment three will be different. So the whole bill will not be standing at the aging of the total amount. You are going to have 4 different bills or 5 different bills depending on the installment for the purpose of aging analysis. Like here is an example. Let's take there was an vendor bill for ABC Consultants of $20,000 on 30th of September. So when I'm going to use my vendor installment feature into the NetSuite, it is going to break down my $20,000 bill to ABC Consultant into four installments of $5,000 each. So installment one, that will be due on 30th of October, next on 30th of November, on 30th of December, and the last installment will be on 30th January. So this is how the installments will be bifurcated into, the whole bill will be bifurcated into 4 installments of $5,000 each. And as and when they become due, they will start showing you into the payment status. Also, when balance overdue or the finance charges that will be calculated for late payments as per the contract rates between you and the vendor, those will be calculated on per installment basis, and every installment will be treated as a different bill for the purpose of aging analysis also. So it provides you with flexibility of the due dates and the payment terms. So this is how the vendor installment payments actually helps into the NetSuite application. Now moving on to my NetSuite application. This is my NetSuite application. The first step will be to set up the vendor installments into the NetSuite application. Now, in order to set up the vendor installments into the NetSuite application, there are 3 things under the accountings tab of the enable features that I will have to check. One is AR, AP, other one is AP. Then I will have to check installments over here, this checkbox, manage installments and related payments for AP and AR. So once you have checked it, you are going to save it. So once you have saved it, the next is you will have to create a payment term, as in an installment payment term for the purpose of payment. So whenever you are paying any vendor with the help of for installments, you're going to select that payment term that you have created, and it will automatically break the whole amount of the bill into 4, 5, 6, how many installments that you have actually set up. So over here into the accounting list, so as you can see, these are the terms of payment that I have into my system. I have already created 4 installments term of payment for the purpose of installment payments. So this is my detail where I have selected installments as the term of payment. I've named it as four installments term. That means the amount of bill will be bifurcated into four equal installments. Now there is one thing that we need to keep in mind when I am creating the terms. Recurrence, frequency, it depends what is the frequency of payment. You have a monthly frequency, you can have a daily frequency, you can have an annual frequency also. So you can select this recurrence count. Now this is how many installments do you want to set up. Here you can select 5, 6, 4 installments, 3 installments, depending on the terms of payment that have been set up into the contract between you and the vendor. And repeat every 1 month, or you can even have repeat every 2 months if you want to pay 4 installments over in 8 months of time, splitting evenly. So it depends on what is the repetition period. You can select the repetition period in months, 1, 2, 3 months, depending on again the terms of the contract. Now here one thing is, either you are going to select split evenly, so that means the terms of payment will be split evenly automatically. If you do not select it, you can yourself provide for every installment amount. That is, one, if you have a $20,000 bill, you can select 3,000, 4,000, 5,000, then 7,000. So it depends on how do you want to pay the vendor. I would prefer split evenly is the normal terms, where you split the whole amount evenly across 4 months, 5 months, depending on your installment term. Now pay tax upfront, how does this play a role into the installments? We'll be looking up this with the help of an example. Now this is my four installment terms payment, which I'll be selecting when I'm going to pay a vendor. Moving on, I have a purchase order pending to be billed. PO number 145, it is pending to be billed. Now, as you can see, it is a demo for installment. I've already set a memo for this. Now, the amount for this bill is 20,000 is my items total and 4,000 is the total of the tax. So the total bill is of 24,000. Now let me click on bill. Yes. Now here I'm going to select the terms of payment. So now as you can see, I have selected four installment terms that we have just seen. This has divided the total amount of the bill into four equal installments due on 20th of November, 20th of December, 20th of January and 20th of February. So this is taken from the date of the bill. The date of the bill was 20th of October. Here is the date, and you can it is going to automatically take up the due dates for the next 4 months, because we have selected 1 month recurrence period. So it has taken up 1 month. Had we selected 2 months, it would have been 20th of November, 20th of January, 20th of March and 20th of May. So this is how it would have been taken up the due dates. Now here, as we can see, these are the amounts. $6,000 amount installment. It is split evenly, and these are the four installments. The amount of the bill is 24,000. Now I'm just canceling it. I'll be going to my accounting list. This was my terms of payment, the four installment term. Now I'm going to check my pay tax upfront box and save it. Now moving back to my purchase order, for which I will be creating a bill. I'm going to again click on my bill. Yes. Now the terms of payment that I am selecting is four installment term that we had created, in which we have just made a change. Now, as you can see, pay tax upfront. So the $4,000 tax that we had seen is paid in the first installment, and the rest is divided equally into installments. So that is $20,000 is equally divided into four installment, and $4,000 is paid upfront, that is into the first installment. So this is $5,000 plus $4,000 tax that is being paid. When we hadn't checked the pay tax upfront box into the terms of when we are creating the terms of payment, the amount of the total bill, that is 24,000, was equally divided into four installments of 6,000 each. So this is the difference between paying the tax upfront and not checking the paying tax upfront box and not checking the paying tax upfront box. Now here I want to pay the installment, I want to pay the tax upfront. All done this, I am going to save it. So as you can see, this particular bill has been saved. Now let us check this into the payment status. So now as you can see over here, I have got the same bill as four different bills. One bill is on 20th of November, the other is on 20th of December, then 20th of January and 20th of February. The amount here is 9,000, that is $5,000 installment plus $4,000 tax, $5,000 again, then 5,000 and then 5,000. So when I'll be making an aging analysis report also, this particular bill will not, these four particular bills will be counted from the date they become due. So this $15,000 will not be counted as aged from 20th of November. It will be counted as aged from 20th of December. So this is how my vendor installments help me, vendor installments feature of the NetSuite application help me to manage my payments, get and make the payments to the vendors more flexible, make the terms of payment flexible, and also along with that, the aging analysis that is done, the late fee charges, penalties, etc., or are also charged at the amount of the payment due or the amount of the installment, and not on the total amount of my bill. So this is all from my side. In case you've got any queries, questions or doubts, you can of course get back to us at www.bispsolutions.com.